first OKR? My first experience with OKRs, I think like many others, it's almost you get pulled right into them because someone else knows how to write them and use them. And so for me, it was, I was working with Mikey Dickerson on the healthcare.gov rescue. Mikey was a Googler. He was part of the rescue team. We are trying to figure out how to articulate what, you know, success criteria looked like for actually fixing this website. And he did it so masterfully, right? He took all the things that we were talking about and said, well, our objective is clear. It's to fix the website for the vast majority of people. And, you know, that's measured by, we have 7 out of 10 people getting through the system. We have 99% uptime. We've got an error rate of 1%. And the thing is, it was so clarifying because we had, you know, barely a person could get through the website. The uptime was, you know, not 99%. It was like in the 40s, which means it wasn't working at all. The error rate was at 12%. So this OKR that he crafted, he just wrote it on the board, right? Fix the website. These are the 3 to 4 different measures that we're going after. And then that just stayed there day in and day out for the next month. And so that was my first experience with them. And knowing how clear and concise, that's why at least when, you know, I think we all embody the OKR feedback that we've experienced, you know, and it's working really well. And so from that experience, I always like to remind, like, conciseness is key, right? Mm. Like picking the few measures as well that really matter is important as well too. So that was my first experience with them, Elizabeth. And that was kind of thrown right into the fire.
You know, what's cool about that is like the physical nature of it is so nice. And I think it's really hard in a remote environment. Like, cause like, we do like a, let's say you do like a weekly call. Like, I guess you keep bringing it up and stuff like that, but there's something that feels unnatural about that. Like a little forced versus just it having a place on the wall as like a reminder. And I think that would be even more powerful. I always like when some companies like have like those like dashboards where like a sale goes, like you're in their office and a sale goes off and people are going like nuts and things like that. I really like that like environmental design around things going well. Because yeah. You do want to feel that, you want to feel that motion as well, rather than just check in a quarter later and be like, okay, it worked. You know, it's like, yeah. It should feel good along the way as well.